Rahim, wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with infinite blessings, and amongst those are that we are able to do good deeds. And many a times when a person does good deeds, instead of they getting more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and instead of more humbleness developing in us or in me, I would say, self-likeness and arrogance starts developing. Now, why does this happen? Because the person thinks, I have done this good deed and I've got promise of paradise, because in the hadith or in the Quran it mentions that actually that I will enter paradise because of these good deeds, and I have done many of them. So when a person thinks I am better and I am a heavenly person, obviously they will think they are better than others, and people who are sinful, and also they themselves in their inner self will become fond of themselves, and then laziness towards good deeds, not abstaining from haram, these things start developing, and arrogance. Now the solution, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned in one of the hadith which is narrated by Imam Muhammad Nishapuri rahmullah with his sanad, sahih sanad, that the Prophet ﷺ once mentioned to the Sahaba ikram, this one the ajma'in, that whoever says man qala la ilaha illallah dakhala al jannah wa lahul jannah, that the Prophet ﷺ said, whoever will say la ilaha illallah, this is a great dhikr, afzalul dhikr, he will enter paradise, and paradise is for him. It has become wajib, necessary for him to, he will definitely enter paradise. And then the Prophet ﷺ says, whoever says Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him with 1024 good deeds, hasanat, virtues. Now the Sahaba ikram said, Qalu ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if this is the case, then none of us will actually enter hellfire, none of us will actually be suffer in any way, because there are so many virtues. So this was the question asked by the Sahaba Rizwanullah Majmain, the companion. And many a times we also hear about different virtues, and then we think, okay, yes, we are in paradise, we will definitely go to paradise. So instead of developing a bond relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we start to rely upon the deeds. Whilst the purpose of ibadah is to connect with Allah. That's why dua is called mukhul ibadah, the essence of ibadah, because dua directly, immediately, with immediate effect, connects one with Allah jalla majduhu. So many people actually have this misconception. And the Sahaba Rizwan Ajmain asked this question, which removes this actually misunderstanding, because the Prophet Al Islam then himself explained, he Al Islam then explained. I will just mention some commentary and then mention the hadith as well. That on the day of judgment, the Prophet Al Islam said, on the day of judgment, people will come with so many good deeds that if they are placed at a mountain, the mountain will be suppressed, and feel the weight of them. There will be so many good deeds, there will be such people. But when those good deeds will be put against the blessings which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon a person in this life, the blessing, the ni'mah a person have used. So blessings of life, blessings of time, blessing of place, blessing of health, blessing of eyes, blessing of the heart, blessing of other money, property, people, friends, peace, sun, the moon, the star, they are all blessings. So on the day of judgment, if you do not know, now you should know that good deeds will come, bad deeds will also be there, and also the good deeds will be weighed against the blessings as well. And in another hadith it comes that one person will come with 500 years of worship, and when the blessing of eyes that that person have been seeing. Such, how a great blessing is, look, I am seeing, you are seeing the colors and things and information we are receiving. It's a great blessing. You are seeing the scenery everywhere. So this blessing will be put on the scale, and his ibadah, 1 year's ibadah, 2 years ibadah, 3 years, still the blessing of eye will outweigh it, until 400-500 years of ibadah and good deeds will be put, and just the blessing of seeing and enjoyment of seeing and the blessing of eyes will outweigh all 500 years of ibadah. So the Prophet ﷺ said to the Sahaba that good deed, yes, I am saying that a person, if he does this, he will get these virtues, he will enter paradise. But firstly, they will be weighed against the blessings as well. And when that will happen, he said that no good deeds will remain of that person who brought mountain, meaning actually of good deeds. Then he, alayhi salatu wasalam, said, when there will be no virtues left, blessings will still be there, then Allah Azza wa Jal, with His mercy, with His rahmah, with His grace and fadl, will make people, will allow people to enter paradise, not just out of good deeds. So Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will bless, okay, they have done good deeds, although they are not worthy of going to paradise because the blessings outweighed them, but because they have done some good deeds, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, out of His fadl and rahmah, so only people will go in Jannah with the rahmah of Allah, not just actually good deeds. So I should not actually develop self-likeness, conceit, arrogance actually in myself or towards the other because of if I am doing good deeds, but rather more humbleness and humility that Allah is blessing me with good deeds and doing the good deeds I am doing, because whatever I do, good deed I do, it is with the blessings of Allah. I'm using wealth given by Allah. I'm using time given by Allah. If I prostrate, I'm using my head given by Allah. If I'm saying Subhanallah, the tongue is given, the mind is given by Allah. So I should become more humble towards Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala and also towards the creation of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala and not be arrogant and be connected with Allah and always rely upon Him and His fadl and rahmah. So may Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala wa Jalla ala enable me to consider and reflect upon this and correct our understanding. Jazakum Allah khairan jaza. Subhanakallahumma bihamdi. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu.